Hey everyone, it's been a long time, again. In this video, I will be answering the most asked question, how do we get more home decor funds? I know some of you already know how, but for the sake of those who don't, here is a video for you guys. Well, aside from the obvious pay to win fact, which is to go to mall, on sale, where you can get a maximum of 20 home decor funds set for 158 coupons each. I think this was 220 before and they lessened the price, or maybe my memory is just faulty. But yeah, basically to get like 30k home decor funds per week easily, you can top up 3,160 coupons, which is about $50 real life money. It's very expensive, like everything else in the game actually. Anyways, we're not going to focus on that and instead talk about how to get home decor funds for free. First of all, do your solo and group dailies. By completing these dailies, you get activity points which fills up the activity bar. First activity box gives you 28, second one gives you 40, third gives 46, fourth gives 54, fifth gives 60, and the sixth one gives 72. So just by completing the activity bar, you get a total of 300 decor funds per day. Now, while doing these dailies, especially the group dailies, Dragon Hunting, Devil Awake, Midnight Pumpkin, and the time-limited event, Undersea Massacre, you have a chance of getting home decor fund box during the card flipping part, which gives a random number of decor funds, which definitely helps a lot. It's based on RNG though, so there are days that you'll get it, and there are also days that you get nada. Second is by collecting red packets. You have a chance of getting home decor funds while collecting red packets. However, it's still based on RNG though, but still, whenever you collect a red packet, there's like a freebie in it, e.g. gold coins or eternal flames, etc. So I recommend that you really max out your red packet collection for the day if you can. Third one is by completing milestones for your home growth. Click your avatar, click growth, then home. You'll see that there are goals you have to do, like holding parties and reaching a specific grade for it, getting 58 endorse points in the creative workshop, and reaching a specific home coziness level. Don't beat yourself over these goals though, because either you'll reach it at one point eventually, or there are much better and faster ways to earn the funds that the goals give, like the ones I've already mentioned. Fourth one is when you go to your home tab, there should be a red dot on clean and decorate. After clicking it, tap the cleanliness icon on the top right, and it will tell you that you can only raid your home when you go inside your homestead. Click confirm, and when inside, click cleanliness, and if you have anything damaged or dirty, make sure that you clean it up and fix it up if you want to maximize the amount of funds that you can get from it. You can simply click details, and then click clean and decorate again, and then click call repairman or hire a maid if you don't have one yet. You can also opt to just fix all of the damaged items yourself so that you don't have to spend around 15 home decor funds anymore. After that, just click cleanliness, then join raiding again and accept. Keep in mind that the amount of funds that you get for this feature depends on the scale of your homestead or house. So if you have a larger house with so much more stuff in it, then your scale and rewards will increase. The fifth source of home decor funds are the weekend night packs. The second, fourth, and sixth night packs give out 150, 150, and 300 home decor funds respectively, for a total of 600 for the first day of the weekend. So you can get 1,200 home decor funds worth from the night packs per week. Okay, so now let's go to the gardening system. This is like a steady supply of home decor funds, if you're not lazy like me. Anyways, first thing to know is that you can only plant on 12 gardening pots at a time. Inside your homestead, click edit, then feature, then garden, and choose from one of the three pots. Aside from the design and cost, the only difference that these pots have is the cozy points that they add to your homestead. Half of the cost of the item is its cozy points, so 320 home decor pot gives 160 cozy points, 360 gives 180, and 480 gives 240 cozy points. This applies to all of the items in the homestead. To start planting, just click on the gardening pot and the choose plant interface will appear. Naturally, you'll have zero of each seeds, so to purchase seeds, just click get. Now you can choose from 6 plants and 3 flowers. However, if you're still starting out or if you don't have enough cozy points yet, you can only buy from the plants section green seed, pepper seed, onion seed, and mushroom seed, since they don't require any cozy points for you to be able to buy them. For carrot seed and tomato seed, you need to have 5,000 cozy points, which you can achieve by putting furniture or decorations in your homestead that will sum up to 5,000 cozy points. For the flowers section, the only seed that you can plant without any cozy points requirement is the rose seed. For lily seed, you need 5,000 cozy points, and for the tulip seed, you need 10,000 cozy points. Each corresponding plants have different growth cycles or the number of hours you have to wait to be able to harvest it. This is a table that I made to show the required cozy points and the growth cycle of each plant in one page. As a lazy person, I just chose to plant tulips for all of the 12 pots because it's the one that takes the most time and cozy points, so it should have the most output, right? I haven't really tested out how much decorfuns really come out from each plant and flowers, but I do know that rose gives 24 and tulips give 42. If we're talking about the most home decorfuns per hour mathematically, I can't give you the figures for it, unfortunately. If you know how much you can harvest from all of the plants, please let us know in the comments below so we can find out together the most efficient plant or flower that can give the most funds per hour. Furthermore, even if nobody steals from your plants, there is still a chance that you won't get the maximum number of home decor funds that you're supposed to get, especially if you didn't take care of your plants during its growth cycle, or if you didn't harvest it for a long time. So if you're diligent, make sure to check your garden every now and then by going to Home, click Garden, and see if there are actions that are needed to be done to ensure that you'll be harvesting the full amount of home decor funds you expect from it. Also, there's a bonus for planting flowers. You have a chance of getting flowers, the one that you use for gifting your friends, that flower. Okay, so the next one is helping your friends with their garden. You can help your friends 10 times per day with the problems in their garden, but you'll only get rewards on the first two times that you helped for the day. The reward is called Garden Help Gift Box, where you have a chance of getting 10 to 100 home decor funds per gift box. Next one is stealing from your friend's garden. You can do this twice a day. It's not my most recommended way though, since it only gives you very little funds most of the time, like around less than 10 or 12 home decor funds. Aside from the small amount of funds, it also gives you garden supply, where you have a chance of getting the following shown in the video. So that's it. Let us know in the comments below if you know a way to earn home decor funds that I wasn't able to include in this video. I've been focusing in school, so I haven't been uploading, and I'm sorry for that. Dragon Raja really hasn't been enjoyable for me nowadays too. But I'll try my best to make more videos about it again when I can, or maybe share with you guys a new game that I found. Well, as always, see you and happy gaming.